Okay, good morning class, welcome back. The topic for today is plateaus and its classification. We are going to do what is the meaning of plateau. In the previous class we had done mountains, the different types of mountains, how it is formed, the importance, and we had done its classification along with the diagram. Now today is the second last topic. Alright, the second last topic is plateaus, and we are going to do the plains, the last topic, in the next class because it is quite long. Okay, now what do you mean by plateau? What actually is a plateau? Now in simple terms, a plateau is an elevated land which is almost horizontal or flat at the top, and then its sides are slanting. Okay, the slope at the side, it is slanting, and at the top it has a large surface area. Now sometimes a mountain may be pointed. Okay, it may have a very small surface area at the top. Now because of, you've done withering and denudation, so you know what is the meaning of denudation and withering. So because of all these processes, because of denudation and withering, the upper layer of the mountain, the topmost layer, may be eroded, and then it may have a flat top. So sometimes this is also how a plateau is formed. Okay, now this is the basic one. Now we are going to do, actually there are, in your book only plateaus are given only of three types, there is intermountain, piedmont, and the continental, but there is an explanation for the lava plateaus also. Okay, how are plateaus formed? Because of the volcanic lava. So we are going to do this, so you can divide it into four parts. Okay, now the first one is the intermountain plateau. So the inter means in the interior, okay, and mountain means interior of the mountains. So this is a mountain, okay, this is a mountain, and this is a plateau. Okay, so you can look at a book also. So a plateau which is surrounded by mountains. A plateau which is surrounded by mountains on all sides is known as an intermountain plateau. So here you just have to learn the definitions. First, what is a plateau? A plateau is an elevated land. Okay, a plateau is an elevated land having a flat top. Okay, and you have to remember is sometimes the sides may be sloping downwards. Okay, maybe sloping downwards. Sometimes there may be plateaus which has a slope only on one side. Okay, we are going to do this also. But the first one, the first type of plateau, is a plateau which is surrounded by mountains. So that kind of plateau which is surrounded by mountains is known as an intermountain plateau. And the example of intermountain is the Tibetan plateau. Tibetan plateau. So definition and example. Example of an intermountain plateau is the Tibetan plateau. Now comes the second type or the second classification of a plateau, which is known as the Piedmont plateau. Now these type of plateaus are formed at the foothills of the mountains. Okay, these are formed at the foothills of the mountain. This is a mountain. At the foothills, at the base, this is the flat surface plateau, and then on one side, like I said, some plateaus may have a slanting slope only on one side. So this is a mountain, the base, at the foothills, this is the Piedmont plateau, and you can see that on one side it is sloping. On one side it is sloping. So this type of plateau is known as a Piedmont plateau. Now The example of a Piedmont plateau is the Malwa plateau. And you know that this is in India. So please remember the definition along with the examples. Okay, now the third type of plateau. This is known as the continental plateau. Now, you know that when we were learning about the endogenous forces that acts on the surface of the earth, that means those forces that is acting on the surface of the earth form the interior. Okay, now because of these forces, a part of the land moves upwards, okay, than the surrounding area. So you can see that from the surrounding area, see, a part of the land has moved upwards, okay. Now this movement has created a plateau known as the continental plateau. So you can say that these type of plateau are formed because of the continental shift. That means the land masses are moving, okay? And especially these occurs when the entire continental landmass is moving around, and because of the movement from the interior of the earth's surface, it rises above the, that part of the land rises above the sea level. So this type of plateau, the formation of this type of plateau is known as the continental plateau, and it is also formed because of the shift in the continent. Okay, and it is formed when a part of the land is shifted because of the continental shift, and it moves upwards, and it is exposed. Part of the land is exposed because it moves out of the water. Okay, so this part is known as the continental plateau. Now the last one. Now the name itself suggests. The name itself suggests that it is formed because of volcanic activities. Now for example, from a volcano, lava oozes out. That means lava is coming out. Now this lava, okay, now just imagine this is a piece of land with rugged terrain. Now this lava, now you know that some lava which is acidic or which is basic, so a lava when it flows in a horizontal area, now you know what kind of lava flows over a horizontal area, because it is thin, the basic one. Because it is thin, it flows over a large horizontal area, okay, and then it forms, because of the large area that it has covered, it forms a horizontal plateau known as the lava plateau. Okay, so again I'm going to repeat, because of the lava which oozes out from the volcano, this lava flows over a larger horizontal area, and thus it forms a lava plateau. So the four different types of classification is, okay, example of the lava plateau is parts of Maharashtra, which is adjacent to the Deccan plateau. You know that because you know that cotton is grown in South India because it has black soil. Okay, and black soil is required for the growth of cotton, and black soil oozes out because of the lava coming out from the volcano. Okay, the black soil is formed because of the volcano which has come out from the volcano. All right, okay, so this is the four classification that we are going to do of the plateaus. Now you also have to learn a few things regarding the plateau. First is, obviously it is an elevated land with a flat top. Now the other term that is used for a plateau is a table land. A plateau is also known as a table land, and I've already told you sometimes The plateau is also formed because of the withering, the denudation and the withering that causes. So a flat top is formed. And another thing that you have to know is a plateau is higher than a plain but is lesser in height than a mountain. We already learned that a mountain may be more than 900 meters above sea level. So, and a plain is a flat surface. So, a plateau is an elevated area. Obviously, it has to be elevated, but it is, its height is lesser than a mountain, but greater than a plain. Alright. Okay, so we shall be doing this much till today. In the next class, I shall be describing about the last topic, that is the plains. Okay, that is the plains, and we are going to do about the different types of plains, that is the classification of plains as well. Thank you.